Hi everyone, welcome to our home learning today. Our topic for today is Unit 17. It's all about heat. In this unit, let's find out what is our main source of heat, what are some other sources of heat, how do people, animals, and plants use heat from the sun, how does too little or too much heat from the sun affect people, animals, and plants? What should we do to avoid getting hurt by heat from the sun? What can we use to measure how hot or cold something is? And how do we safely handle objects that produce heat? For our science glossary in this unit, we have these following words. Bask means live in a place without shelter and enjoy the warmth of the sun. Hibernate means be in an inactive state of sleep during winter. Panels are flat and rectangular pieces of material. Temperature is the measure of how hot or cold a thing is. Thermometer is an instrument used to measure temperature. And wilt means dry up and slowly die. So what are sources of heat? Sources of heat are things that produce heat. Heat makes things warm. The sun is our main source of heat. The heat from the sun keeps the earth and living things on the earth warm. Besides the sun, there are other sources of heat. We have burning wood, burning gas, and electrical equipment or appliances such as ovens and irons are some other examples of sources of heat. So let's take a look for the following pictures here. We have burning wood, burning gas, electric iron, and oven. So let's go now to using heat from the sun. For people, we use heat from the sun to dry many objects like wet clothes, shoes, and mattresses. We also use heat from the sun to dry food. Some people use special panels on rooftops to gather heat from the sun. The heat is used to warm water in water tanks. The warm water can be used for bathing and washing. On animals, some animals depend on the heat from the sun to keep their body warm. These animals bask themselves in the sun to obtain heat. This heat enables their body to function normally. Plants need heat from the sun to live and grow. Seeds only start to grow when there is warmth from the sun. Effects of too little heat and too much heat from the sun. On people, we will feel cold and we may even shiver if we get too little heat from the sun. We have to wear thicker clothes or use other sources of heat to keep us warm. The heat from the sun makes us perspire. When we perspire, we lose water and heat from our body. Perspiring helps to cool our body down and prevent us from overheating. When our body gets too much heat from the sun, we lose a lot of water from our body through our perspiration. If our body loses too much water, we may get muscle cramps, feel dizzy, or even faint. How to avoid getting hurt from too much heat? Too much heat can harm our body. We should not stay out in the sun for too long, and instead should take short breaks in shady places. When we are out in the sun, we should drink plenty of water to replace the water that our body loses when we perspire. On animals, animals are affected if the places they live in receive too little heat from the sun. Some animals move away from their homes to warmer places in the winter months to avoid the cold weather. Other animals become inactive and hibernate throughout the winter months to conserve energy. Like people, animals can be harmed by too much heat from the sun. Their bodies lose a lot of water and will not be able to function properly. In the desert, some animals stay underground during the day to to avoid the heat from the sun. On plants, if plants get too little heat from the sun, they will not be able to make enough food to grow properly. Some plants will stop growing shoots and flowers. Seeds will also not start to grow if there is too little heat from the sun. If there is too much heat from the sun, plants will lose a lot of water from their leaves. As a result, the plants will wilt. If a wilted plant does not get any water in time, it will die. So let's go now to using heat from other sources. For keeping warm, we use heat from burning wood and burning gas to cook food. We also use heat from electrical equipment or appliances to cook food and to boil water. For keeping warm, in very cold weather, we use heat to keep warm. For drying, we use heat from the electrical equipment or appliances to dry things. Measuring hot or cold. Temperature is a measure of how hot or cold something is. We can use our skin to feel whether an object is hot or cold. However, our skin cannot tell us the temperature of the object. To get an accurate temperature, we should use a thermometer. Temperature is measured in degrees Celsius. There are different types of thermometers. Different types of thermometers are used for different purposes. We use a clinical thermometer to measure the temperature of our body. The normal human body temperature is about 37 degrees Celsius. How do we read a temperature? We use a laboratory thermometer to measure temperature in science experiments. These are the steps for reading the temperature from a thermometer. First, hold the thermometer upright. Second, look at the level of the liquid. Third, position your eyes at the same level as the liquid in the thermometer. And last, read the marking nearest to the level of the liquid in the thermometer. How to properly handle objects that produce heat? We should not use our bare hands to touch hot objects. We can use tongs or put the hot object on a cooler plate or saucer. We should not go too near the oven when it is hot. If we need to take food out of it, we should ask an adult to help us. We should use oven gloves to handle hot food. And lastly, we should turn off the flame of the gas after use. That ends our lesson for today. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye and God bless.